flipping heck, look at this. This is as tall as a PlayStation 5.
So then guys, I'm gonna do something a little bit unusual today. I'm actually gonna do a comparison of a Windows desktop small factor to the M2 Pro Mac Mini. And what I bought is one of these. This here is a Minisforum desktop computer, but it's a really, really slim machine. And actually in this machine here, I know it looks a bit like a PlayStation 5 and I'll get onto that. This machine actually houses inside of it a Nvidia 3060 and also holds inside it a i5 Intel chipset inside it, a mobile variant, and also it also holds 16 gigabytes of RAM. And I thought to do a fair comparison, like I said, I'm going to compare it to the M2 Pro Mac Mini and see what the differences are between both of these machines. Now this machine that you see here is called the NUCXi5 and it is quite special. I really, really love the design of this machine. And you can see here in the comparison, compared to my PlayStation 5 and also to the M2 Mac Mini, you can see how the design is very striking and looks really, really awesome. From both sort of angles, you can see how thin it is, and also it is particularly long. Now, the main reason why it is particularly long is actually what's housed inside this machine is actually a laptop motherboard. And inside that, we actually have upgradable RAM, and also we can also upgrade the SSD inside this machine. Now, what I decided to do, or why I decided to pick this machine, is I thought it would be a fair comparison compared to the Mac Mini with the M2 Pro chipset inside it. The price here, as you can see on Minisforum, I spec'd it out with 512 gigabytes. And also, as you can see here, I've got the 16 gigabytes of RAM. And I thought, you know, this is probably the best sort of machine that you can get on your desk. What looks quite smart, has a dedicated graphics, which is probably gonna be very comparable to what we have in the Mac Mini. And I wanted to see what the differences were between both of these models. And that if it's worth getting yourself, say, a Windows device, and what would be the main advantage of either getting the Mac Mini or either this NUCXi5 device instead from Minisforum. So first of all, I did an unboxing. So as you can see here, the unboxing sort of process was very, very simple indeed. Nice, good box inside. I got everything out. And also you do also get a stand to stand it on. So you can either have this device landscape or you can either have it portrait. It's up to you basically how you want to have it. You can have it standing up or lying down as I showed you a bit earlier on. It comes with Windows 11 pre-installed and everything was quite easy to set up with this machine and I was very, very impressed. And one of the first things I actually noticed about this desktop was actually to do with cooling and the amount of vents that are on it. You can see here, you've got a massive vent on the back of this device and also you've got multiple vents all around it to keep it nice and cool. And we'll do some thermal tests a little bit later to show what that is all about and how well that actually works. But it looks very, very positive indeed to start with. So to start with the comparisons, the first thing I've decided to do is do a Geekbench sort of scoring sort here. And as you can see here, I started off with Geekbench on this Windows 11 device here, and it's got an Intel 11th generation i5, and also at the same time, like I said, 16 gigabytes of RAM and so on and so forth. And as you can see here, the single core performance is quite powerful, but the multi-core performance inside this obviously is quite low. It's nowhere near what we get with say the M2 Pro. As you can see here, what I also run on the Geekbench 5, you can see here it is far higher. In fact, I'd actually argue that the Geekbench score that I got here on this machine is more comparable to say the advantage of say a sort of lower end sort of M1. But then having said that, we've got to remember this is also an 11th generation chipset inside this device where Intel are on their 13th generation right now. But I'm thinking that we're gonna get gains probably in sort of the GPU power inside this machine, definitely that it's got this dedicated Nvidia 3060 inside it. I next of all decided to run a Cinebench score. So as you can see here, comparing both of them, so for single core scores on Cinebench, they're quite close. The 11th generation Intel got 1,450 and the M2 Pro got 1,648. And do remember that single core is the same cores that we have in the normal M2, M2 Pro and the M2 Max. But again, it's not really that much difference as we can see here. It's quite close like in Geekbench.
But moving over to multi-core score, things do change a fair bit here. Remember, with that Intel chipset, we do have far less cores in it. So we only got 8,867, whereas the M2 Pro, we have all those additional cores inside. So it's a much more of a beastier machine, and it got us 14,698. That's about a 40% speed difference. But overall, as you'll see in a minute, this might not mean a lot too much of when we're doing video editing and also playing games to do with actual CPU performance.
So after running this Cinebench, and remember this Cinebench was a 10 minute test, I decided to run the 30 minutes of Cinebench on both of these devices. And the main thing I wanted to see was to do with the actual cores and how hot they get inside them. Now, quite surprising, as you can see here, on the Mac Mini running into doing this test on Cinebench, the cores got really, really hot. We're talking about 90 degrees and things like this. Whereas on the actual Minisforum machine here, actually the temperature only got into the 70s, as you can see here. So it was actually much more cooler, the chipset inside it. Now, I must admit, the fan did wear up a little bit inside this Minisforum as compared to Apple, but it does seem like Apple do allow their chips to go much hotter before they start kicking in with that actual fan. And as you can see here, the fan didn't really kick in at all. The RPM sort of stayed low with doing this 30 minute sort of Cinebench that I did here, the benchmark testing. And just in case you wanted to hear what the difference was with the fan noise, here's the Minisforum with the fan on when it was doing the Cinebench. And here's the fan noise on the Mac Mini M2 Pro. So as you can see, the Mac Mini M2 Pro, no noise at all. But there's a slight little hum with the Minisforum, and it's really, really good. And I think the main reason is, like I said, it's to do with all of these vents that are on this device. So that is pretty, pretty impressive, in my opinion, for what we're getting. But the main thing what you probably want to see is to do with actual thermals on the outside of the casing. How hot do these actual devices get? Well, let me show you right here. So the outside of the device here, you can see that the temperatures are around about 34, 35 degrees on the Minisforum. And funny enough, on the Mac Mini, it's also around the same. The cooling on the actual outside of the cases is about on par with each other. So you're not really going to see much differences here. Both these devices are not going to melt their way through into your desk, even though they're running, say, something hardcore like this Cinebench sort of 30 minute test. The next test what I decided to do after this was to do a Blackmagic, and this is to test out the actual sort of hard drive speeds, the SSD drives, and how fast they are inside both of these devices. So I ran them on both of the devices, as you can see here, and straight away you can see the Mac Mini is doing quite a good performance, even though we've had sort of some NAND chips sort of removed here, but it's doing quite well for what it is for an M2 Pro. And then comparing it here to the Minisforum, you can actually see that obviously, yep, it is a bit more slower inside this device. But I guess the main sort of difference what we got to actually see is to do with Premiere Pro. So what I've decided to do is do an export of videos on both of these devices to see what the difference is going to be. Premiere Pro and things like DaVinci are like the only sort of main sort of tools that we can use out there, because obviously Final Cut Pro cannot be used on, say, the Windows device. So I decided to do something in Premiere Pro. I've decided to export the same sort of 10 minute video, and here are the results.
So straight away, as you can see, the Intel 11th generation with that 3060, even though earlier when we were doing those Geekbench and that Cinebench, that dedicated graphics means a lot. And that's the main reason why, you know, you could consider this machine for video editing, because that dedicated graphics helps. It actually exported this file in 194 seconds, whereas the M2 Pro, the Mac Mini, did it in 183 seconds. Now, obviously, that is 11 seconds faster, but in the grand scheme of things, if you just look at this chart, it's very, very close. 11 seconds is not a lot, and especially with the 3060, this is also a gaming machine too, what I'll talk about a little bit further on into the video. And the M2 Pro chipset is not really a fully sort of graphics sort of machine for gaming. It is mainly for sort of video editing and photo editing. So yeah, it's quite interesting to see that both the results are very, very close.
So as you can see, those results are pretty impressive to have with both of these devices. So that is quite cool, especially that dedicated GPU and what that's doing for the Miniforum's device. after this, what I decided to do was actually do a bit of gaming. Now, this is where I think the main difference is where you're going to have both of these devices. Both of these devices, as you've seen, are more than capable of sort of being able to do sort of video editing, but I want to see what gaming is like. And let's have a look here, first of all, with the Mac Mini. So I'm using here Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and what I decided to do was one of these sort of Geekbench sort of built-in sort of scores inside it. And I ran this and everything looks quite smooth and quite good. And as you can see here on the end screen, you can see the minimums and you can see the maximums and the average here as well of 30 frames per second. But what happens now if I run this on the Miniforums machine? This device, like I said, has that Nvidia 3060, what is a laptop variant of the chipset. But let's see what happens here now. As you can see here, I'm running Shadow of the Tomb Raider again. And obviously everything is set to ultra high, what's exactly the same on the Mac Mini. And let's have a look at the results that came back in the end. You can see here, look at that. We're in way into the hundreds here of the minimum and the maximums. This is absolutely just blows away the Mac Mini. And even the average frames per second, you know, yeah, that's completely blown away the M2 Pro Mac Mini. So for gaming, no surprise here whatsoever. We knew the Miniforums device was going to absolutely smoke that M2 Pro. At the end of the day, Apple just don't design their devices to be gaming devices, yet they can play a bit of games on them, you know, very moderately and everything, and obviously they have to be tweaked to work with it. But if you do want a device that is going to be sort of more hardcore for gaming, yeah, the Miniforums device is definitely more than worth it. Now, the next thing I want to actually talk about is to do with ports on the actual design and what you're getting on this device here compared to the Mac Mini. So on this Miniforums device, the NUCXi5, yeah, you do get some USB 3.2 ports on the front. You also get an SD card and also a headphone port. But then moving on to the back, things are a little bit different. You don't get any USB ports, traditional one. You do get one Thunderbolt port here on the back. You also get a HDMI and also you get a 1 gigabit gigabit port there too. And that is all the ports that you get. But there again, compared to the Mac Mini M2 Pro, ports are a very different situation than what you get here. The ports to me on here are a little bit more updated. You get two USB 3.1 ports here on the back, but you also get four Thunderbolt ports, HDMI 2.1, but we also get the choice of a 1 gigabit or 10 gigabit option for what we can have inside this Mac Mini M2. In my opinion, I think here that the Mac Mini M2 Pro does win out here. I do actually prefer the ports on here. The only one thing that I do wish there were some ports maybe on the front, because like with the Mac Studio, for example, we get that. And I think that's really, really handy to have those. So I think we've come down to our conclusion, guys. This brand new Miniforum NUCXi5 is a fantastic device, a great buy. And I would definitely recommend getting one of these, especially if you are loving gaming and also you are a creator too. They're really, really good to get, especially if you know like Premiere Pro, for example, and also you know your way around Windows. It is definitely worth buying one of these. But there again, the Mac Mini M2 Pro is really, really good. And also, if you get apps that actually have been configured to be used with the likes of the M1 or the M2 sort of chipsets, the Apple Silicon chipsets out there, you're really going to see the advantages out there for this Mac Mini. Especially like me, where I use Final Cut Pro, I prefer Final Cut Pro to Premiere, but that's just my preference. And for that, it's definitely better for me in doing my creative things. But there again, having said that, if I was to do gaming, oh yeah, it'd be the Miniforum device all the way. But those are my opinions, guys. What are your thoughts on both of these devices? I would love to know. Would you pick the Mac or would you pick the Miniforums device? Let me know in the comments below. And on that note as well, guys, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons like the one we've had today, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Take care. Bye-bye.